developments today on this day 77 of the Gulf oil disaster. Bad weather is slowing down cleanup operations in the Gulf off the coast of Alabama, Mississippi, and Florida. But some skimming boats are out off of Louisiana's coast. BP says it has now spent $3 billion so far on containment, cleanup, and damage claims. Meantime, federal authorities have closed more waters off Louisiana's coast to fishing. About a third of the waters are now off limits to fishing, affecting a lot of livelihoods. Well, joining us now on the phone, Democratic Congressman Charlie Melancon. Charlie, thanks for being with us. Your district covers much of southern Louisiana. And Congressman, I want to ask you, there's still a lot of frustration over BP's payment of claims. Only half of the 95,000 claims filed so far across the Gulf. Are your constituents experiencing the same?
Yes, they are. And part of the problem, particularly with the fishermen, the allocation of $5,000 per fisherman is not adequate to keep these people sustained. So I'm hopeful that once Ken Feinberg gets his shop set up, that we'll start seeing this progress a lot quicker. I pray that it will, because these people are hurting.
Absolutely. Their livelihoods are at stake. Congressman, it's interesting. We just got this new number. $3 billion is what BP has dished out so far. Is there a concern at all that they're going to run out of money before everybody that deserves their share gets it? And what happens if they do?
Well, I hope that they won't, and I hope that they won't be dishonest and look at trying to form up new corporations or shift assets around. Basically, the capitalization of the company should be adequate, and of course, the revenue that's generated. This is just one well. They have operations around the world that have brought in income. So it may hurt them for a period of time, but at the same time, I think that they've got the capacity to earn enough to pay these bills as they go, and to make sure that people are compensated. The sooner this well gets shut down, the sooner we'll have a chance to start assessing what the total damage is, and of course trying to figure out what BP is going to be necessary for BP to pay the people.
And Congressman, you supported a bill. It passed in the House last Thursday. It allows the families of those 11 oil workers that was killed on the Deepwater Horizon rig to be able to sue BP. Can you take us through that legislation and what you think this will do in the future as we face the possibility that this could happen again?
Well, as you know, what happened with that bill, it provided that the spouses and the children will be taken care of. In offshore law, basically all the company had liability to do was to pay for the funeral. And of course, you know, we've not found any of the 11 bodies. So there wasn't even an obligation there, and to pay some meaningful but not necessarily adequate amounts for settlement, and no guarantee that they had to do that. So what this law does is just makes it so that the company has the obligation and the liability, and if not, then the people that have been damaged, the families that have been damaged, would have the ability to sue and seek adequate compensation.
Well, it's interesting. In just a few moments, we're going to be doing a segment on some cities down there on the Gulf Coast. We're going to be asking BP for millions of dollars in mental health costs, meaning clinics that are seeing some of the residents down there suffering from anxiety, depression, millions and millions of dollars, when I'm sure a lot of your constituents would say, listen, I'm out of work. My livelihood's at stake here. I need for XYZ. And there are probably a lot of people in the nation that are saying, well, I'm unemployed, I'm depressed. Does this open up a door that is dangerous for us to go through?
Well, a number of weeks back, it might even be as much as 3 weeks ago, I asked BP to start looking at giving money to Catholic Charities, to the St. Bernard Project, to nonprofits that are out there with organizations that are operating counseling for mental and for stress and depression and these other things that have been brought on by this oil spill. They have the responsibility, and of course in my region, my district particularly, after Katrina and Rita, we had a lot of what they referred to as Katrina fatigue, and we're starting to see people get hopeful and feel like there was a future and building their lives back, getting back into fishing, and seeing the light at the end of the tunnel, and now this has come about and and shut them down again. And then the questions about what the future holds, no one's able to answer those questions in any finite way at this point in time. So,
well, we'll all have to wait and see on many of these developments. But Congressman Charlie Melancon, I want to thank you for being with us this morning and taking the time.
Thank you.
Take care.